Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. Today we're reviewing a fascinating academic article that explores the intersection of artificial intelligence and social work. It's called Considering a Unified Model of Artificial Intelligence Enhanced Social Work, a Systematic Review by Michael Garskich and Laurie Goldkind, published in the Journal of Human Rights and Social Work. Now, you might be thinking, AI and social work, don't these two seem a bit, well, mismatched? And it's true that social work traditionally emphasizes human connection, building trust with clients, understanding their individual needs, and offering empathetic support. These are all hallmarks of the profession. So where does AI fit into this very human-centric field? Well, the authors of this article argue that AI has the potential to enhance social work practice in a number of ways. But I also feel that they stress very strongly the importance of approaching AI integration thoughtfully and ethically. To guide this discussion, what I really like is that the authors very creatively use a framework called the Triple Mandate, which highlights the responsibilities social workers have to their clients, their profession, and their employing agencies. The authors also propose a unified model for artificial intelligence enhanced social work, essentially a roadmap for agencies to follow. I thought that this was a really good use of this framework because it helps explain how we can develop AI-enhanced approaches to social work. Let's begin with the client mandate that emphasizes that social workers should always prioritize the well-being and best interests of their clients. The authors argue that AI tools should be developed and implemented with this mandate at the forefront of social workers' minds. Then the article outlines three key elements within the client mandate. Accountability. Clients have a right to know how AI is being used in their cases and to understand the reasoning behind any decisions made by AI tools. This means ensuring transparency about how algorithms work, what data is being used, and establishing mechanisms for correcting errors or challenging outcomes. This is all about ensuring fairness and giving clients agency in their own cases. Participation and user centricity. The authors stress the importance of client participation and user-centricity in AI development. This means involving clients in the design and testing of AI tools, incorporating their feedback, and making sure these tools are truly user-friendly and responsive to their needs. Imagine, for instance, social workers and clients working together to create an AI tool that helps connect individuals with support groups in their communities. Non-discrimination and inclusion. AI algorithms can sometimes perpetuate existing biases, especially if they're trained on biased data. The authors emphasize that social workers must be extremely careful to ensure that AI tools don't discriminate against any group. For example, an AI tool used in child welfare shouldn't unfairly flag families from certain socioeconomic backgrounds based on pre-existing biases in the data. The profession mandate focuses on the responsibilities of social workers to their profession. This includes engaging in continuous learning, upholding ethical standards, and ensuring that AI is used in a way that aligns with social work's core values. The authors identify several important considerations for social workers in this context: interdisciplinarity and collaboration. Developing and implementing ethical AI in social work requires working closely with experts from other fields like computer science, data ethics and law. This kind of collaboration ensures that AI tools are both technically robust and ethically sound. Think of it as a team effort. Social workers bring their expertise on human needs and social justice, while data scientists bring their technical knowledge to create tools that can make a real difference. AI future skills and continuing education. As AI becomes increasingly sophisticated, the authors argue that social workers need to stay ahead of the curve. This means integrating training on AI ethics, data literacy, and critical evaluation of AI tools into social work education programs. We need a generation of social workers who are not just comfortable with AI, but who can use it wisely and responsibly. Ethical and responsible issues. The authors stress the importance of developing clear ethical guidelines for the use of AI in social work. These guidelines should address issues like data privacy, informed consent, and the potential for bias in algorithms. It's crucial to remember that social work is a profession rooted in human rights and social justice. AI should never be used in a way that violates those principles. In the social agency mandate, the authors highlight the responsibilities social workers have to their employing agencies. This means advocating for the resources, infrastructure, and leadership needed to support the ethical and effective use of AI within social work organisations. The article points to a number of key factors for social agencies to consider: governance, guiding, and monitoring. Implementing AI responsibly requires establishing clear policies, procedures, and oversight mechanisms. For example, this includes things like data security protocols, audits to ensure fairness, and ways to address complaints or concerns from clients or staff. It's about putting safeguards in place to make sure AI is used ethically and effectively. Resources, infrastructure, and data. To use AI effectively, social agencies need access to high-quality data, secure data management systems, and appropriate technology. They also need to invest in training and support for staff. All of this requires adequate funding and a commitment from leadership to promote AI integration ethically. Leadership change and transparency. Integrating AI can be a big shift for a social work organisation. Leaders need to be proactive in managing this change process, communicating clearly with staff, providing ongoing training, and addressing any concerns that may arise. The transition to using AI should be collaborative and transparent, with everyone's input valued. So, what are my key takeaways? Well, for me, this article highlights the exciting possibilities and the complex challenges that come with integrating AI into social work. I felt that the author stressed that AI has the potential to enhance practice in many ways, but it needs to be approached carefully, always keeping the triple mandate in mind. The authors also propose a unified model for artificial intelligence-enhanced social work, essentially a roadmap for agencies to follow. This model emphasises the importance of ethical guidelines, client participation, and collaboration between social workers and AI experts. As the authors argue, AI should be seen as a tool to enhance, not replace, the human connection that's so central to social work. By prioritising the well-being of clients, upholding the profession's ethical standards, and creating supportive agency structures, we can harness the power of AI to build a more just and equitable society. I've provided a link below to this really insightful article, and I would encourage you to read it and apply its messages in your own teaching and practice. Well, that's the end of this video, and as always, I'm curious to hear your thoughts about this topic. Please do leave a comment below and let me know what you think about the video and the article. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any future content. I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye.